because I have a word from the Lord.
Amen.
It is a word that is here to build you up. And to encourage you. And probably to confirm a few things or two. What I want to do is I want to talk briefly about something in the book of Acts. I'm coming out of Acts 17, just one scripture. In him we what?
We live.
In God.
We live.
Uh-huh. Yes. Life is worth the living just because he lives.
We can
face tomorrow because he lives. All fear is gone because we know who holds our future.
Come on.
In him I live.
All right.
In him I what?
Move.
I'm with Sweet 16. Somebody. We're moving. And ain't there one of us in here got a mansion on this earth?
Come on.
Ain't none of us going to the bar, don't believe, drinking liquor by 8 o'clock in the morning and going shopping at Neiman Marcus.
Alright.
So we need to stop fantasizing and move with God.
Alright.
Come on.
I live, I move, and I have my being. In other words, I'm nothing without it.
Alright.
I don't even exist.
Come on, that's right.
Because in him, he breathes the breath of life in our nostrils every day.
Come on now.
That's why we exist.
That's why.
Because of new mercies every morning, we are able to exist.
Go ahead.
I don't want to say much.
I live, I move, I have my being. Because of the mighty God that we serve. Now, in the 17th chapter of Paul.
Acts.
Paul. Paul wrote the book. But in the 17th chapter of Paul, he was doing a little visiting. You know, he was an evangelist. He was an evangelist first. And he's always, that was his main gift. Evangelism. When he got saved, he went from place to place. Witnessing about the gospel and the truth and the love of Jesus Christ. Because he was a hard hearer. You know, he was religious. But the word wasn't in him. See, a lot of folk in the church are religious. They come to church every Sabbath. They know how to pray. They know how to jerk. They know how to shoot up a Honda. They can do all of that. But at the end of the day, they go home raising hell. They pull a mess. They call enough folk on the phone, start a mess. They still come to church an hour late. They still we have got to learn how to walk in God.
Come on.
This man, when he came off of his high horse, and God, the Holy Ghost certainly threw him off the high horse. He looked up and he said, Lord, what would you have me to do?
Come on, Pastor.
God had to blind him for 3 days.
Come on.
Sometimes God got to shut us down for 3 days, 4 days, or 24 hours of fast. But some of us so greedy, we want to eat a whole cow and a whole chicken and a whole cake, and don't nobody want to turn their plate over to fast.
Come on.
But the Word of God said that some things that you need from me, you only going to get it through fasting and prayer. Praise God. We went on a fast last week for Apostle because he was having some difficulty in his body. And I said, oh God, we know what to do. Amen. Me and Elder went on a 24 hours. She said, shut it down. We're going to shut it down. We shut it down for 24 hours. Man, see, we got new definitions of fasting now in this new church age that we're in. We think fasting is not eating chocolate. What the devil? Where that come from? Not eating bread. I ain't going to eat bread for a day. I'm not going to drink a Diet Coke. That's not no fasting, baby. Fasting is when you abstain from. It's making a sacrifice. Your offering. When you fast, you got to pray. we got it. And I'm the man in God. And he said, baby, you can't command God to do nothing if you ain't living nothing. Right. If you ain't living a nickel worth of dog meat, you can't command nothing from the Lord.
Come on.
Now, one time Hezekiah was living something. So Hezekiah turned his face to the wall.
Yeah.
And Hezekiah reminded God about some things.
Uh-huh.
You remember God when I was there.
Oh,
you know I was faithful.
God,
you know I was loyal. You know I walked in your statue. You know I walked in your precinct.
Well,
God sent the man of God back around and tell the man of God, tell the prophet Hezekiah, God just added 15 more years to your life. If you don't have no deposit, don't look for a withdrawal.
Oh, come on.
Hey, make this money.
We want to spend too much time doing crazy stuff, but no, not Evangelist Paul. Paul was about the business of the Lord.
That's right.